Dankeschön.
Ditto. Hey, Nick. Have you had any more thoughts about that money off your end?
There's nothing to think about. I've made my mind up.
Yeah, but it was nice of her, eh?
Yeah, it was nice of her. And I do really appreciate the thought, but I've got my principles, and I'm sticking to them. Hiya, Dan.
Just still hate me?
Of course don't hate you. Why'd you say that?
Because you don't want anything to do with me.
I never said that.
Are you sure?
It's just a difference of opinion, that's all.
You want to take the money then?
No.
Well, tell me why not.
Does anyone want a cup of tea?
Look, I'm late. I haven't got time to explain, but I'll talk to you later.
She's definitely wrong about all this, isn't she?
You haven't been playing silly beggars again, have you?
What are you talking about now?
This Valentine's Day card for Anthony. You haven't sent it, have you?
You're joking, aren't you? I learned my lesson last year. Do you think I'd do that again?
I don't know what your scheming brain's up to sometimes.
Give it here.
It might be private.
Yeah, and it could be from a couple of school bullies.
Well, I feel like we're prying.
Well, I certainly don't.
Not for me?
Yeah. But we thought we'd open it for you.
But just in case it's not a very nice one.
I want to see.
Do you think I should open it for you, son?
No. It's got my name on it, hasn't it?
Do you want me to read it for you?
No, I can read it myself. You can read it now.
Anthony? What does it say?
Leaves in the winter, flowers in the spring. We've got some rope to watch you swing.
Hiya, Nan.
Hello, love.
How are you and I?
So-so.
I've got to go. I'll see you later.
Try.
Jerome, do you and Anne a cup of tea, eh?
Nicky's already gone.
Oh, that's okay. Come to see Jerome.
Oh, I'm going to get ready then, shall I?
Do you want a cup of Jess?
Jerome, are you working at the bingo tonight?
Yeah.
Any chance of a lift?
Yeah, no problem.
Thanks.
But you're going to have to leave with me early, like.
Oh, okay.
And is Bridget coming?
No, not tonight, love. I'll see you later then, okay?
Jack, I'm really glad you brought it over.
Yeah, well, you've got tons of space here. And it only ends up in the garden at all, so...
No, honestly, it's great. So, are you out tonight?
No, Max is working.
No romantic Valentine's night, then?
Well, it might be later if he plays his cards right. What about you?
He's working.
Is he in bed now? I also thought you'd been going round to Bev's. She's having the opening night tonight.
Yeah, I know.
Can you remember my opening night?
By Brookie, of course.
That was 4 years ago, that.
It's gone so quick.
Hasn't it just? It was great then. Look at it now, it's a shambles.
I'm glad that Leanne's gone though.
So am I. I'd love to get a grip of that bar again.
Bet you would.
Me and Max had sorted out. Hey, look what I got them for Valentine's. Do you think you like them?
They're lovely.
Hey, listen, do you fancy coming round to ours tonight? Come on, get away from this lot.
Yeah, we could, I suppose.
Well, Mike's working and so's Max. We could have a couple bottles of wine.
Go on then, but I'll have to bring Beth over.
No, you leave them in there, no one has ever know.
Jackie, you don't mean that.
Of course I do. Yeah, I do.
Hiya, Steve.
I thought you were in work.
Looks like. What's this?
It's me wages from all the jobs I've been doing.
So it's not money from another insurance job?
No, of course not. Oh, you mean...
Yeah. Like the one you and your dad concocted together.
Yeah, well, I was only trying to help.
We had murder over that last night.
Look, it wasn't just his fault.
What wasn't?
Just in time.
Time for what? What's that?
Steve's wages.
Some wages, son.
Well, now I've got Mr. Big and his henchman together. How about a little talk, eh? About this little insurance job?
Okay, boss.
Think so.
Yeah. All nice and tidy, eh? Ready for your big night?
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh. You okay?
Just feels different somehow.
How do you mean?
Well, like a stranger in my own home.
Oh, don't be worrying about that. It's natural, that.
I hope so.
Yeah, you'll be okay when there's people bouncing around in here.
I think so, yeah.
Yeah. Listen, you need to take stock of your life. You know, where you've been, where you're going, all that palaver.
What's the problem, Jim? Not sure anymore.
Okay, okay, I admit it, we were wrong.
But we thought we were right.
Oh, so that's all right then, is it? You risk everything for a few poxy bobs.
Steve had nothing to do with it. He just walked in at the wrong time. It was me and Christy set it up.
I knew that toe rag of being on it. I should have guessed that night in the flaming bar, all the looks and whispering. When are you going to learn?
Dad, we know the score. You've told us off. Can we move on now?
No, it was ages ago. No one's even bothered about it, no.
I am.
We've got more important matters. Our Auntie, for one.
What did Mrs. Plummer say about the card?
What card?
Those two bullies sent our Auntie a nasty Valentine's card.
Oh, the little get.
She said there was no proof.
Proof? What more proof does she need?
She said she's going to be keeping an eye out for them.
Again?
What more can we do, Di?
I don't know. I really don't know.
I'll still be watching out for them as well.
You better go.
You going to be all right?
Yeah.
See you later.
See you later.
Why does everything happen to our family?
There's others worse off.
Is there?
Yeah, loads. Look at them opposite. They've lost everything in that fire.
I suppose you're right.
You know I am. You take on too much sometimes.
It's called being a mother.
Yeah, and you're brilliant at that.
What's this?
500 for you.
Don't be daft.
You deserve it. And I know you're short on cash and I can afford it, so...
But Steve, this is yours.
No, it's yours now. Just don't tell me Dad, you know what he's like. Just go on and on.
Thanks, Steve.
I'm just glad I can help.
I know, and I'm sorry about before. I just didn't feel right taking fiddled insurance money. At least I know this is earned.
So do you see what I mean now?
Well, I do now, yeah.
I mean, I was exactly the same. Uncertain, frightened.
No, I'm more frightened for our Josh.
Oh, don't be worrying about Josh. He's a tough little fella, like our Wills.
Oh, is Wills?
Yeah, he's Sam. He's great.
Why wasn't he at your party last night?
Because the Wailing Banshee one promised to take him to some pancake party, didn't she, hey?
I take it you mean Jackie?
Exactamundo.
Oh, hey, I bet he's grown.
Yeah, yeah, shooting up.
Mm-hmm. Great to see your kids getting on, isn't it?
Yeah, and do you know something? Even when he's not with me, our Wills is always at the back of my head.
Tell me about it. You never stop worrying about them. Mm. Hey, your Wills would have enjoyed himself last night. You did yourself proud.
Oh, thanks, Beth. You know, I'm glad Anthony Murray won. He's been having problems at school, you know. Hasn't had much to smile about.
Oh, you all right, like?
I'd say so, yeah.
You never see him with any mates, do you? You know, playing footy or anything like that.
Oh, that's just the way he is. He'll grow out of it.
Do you know what? I'd hate it if our Josh had no mates and was a loner.
Your Josh will be fine.
I hope so. Suppose he just needs to readjust to his old life. And to me.
No problems there. Everyone loves your Josh. And you. Everyone loves you. I mean it. Anyway, listen, I better shoot. Things to do.
Thanks, Jim.
No problem.
No, I think I need a good talking to.
Didn't you just? Listen, what time do you want me back?
7, OK.
Sam?
That's the time I told Nicky to get in.
Listen, this place will be buzzing again, I'm telling you. Don't you be worrying. See you later.
It wouldn't half help if you took that money off your Emily.
Of course it would. I'm not touching stolen money.
But Nicky is skinned.
Yeah, and I'd sooner stay skinned.
I'm not being funny or anything, but you could do with some new clothes.
Yeah, I know I could. I can't do anything, can I, until the house insurance is sorted.
You could take the money.
Jay, I'm not taking anything.
Whether it's £1,000 or whether it's a quid, I'll be endorsing a crime.
All right, all right. I won't mention it again.
Good.
I just want you to know that you're throwing £1,000 down the drain.
So, are you saying that you'd have taken an offer?
Yeah.
You've got no scruples.
You asked me.
Do you know what you're wasting, Tim?
Nikki, I'm not getting into an argument over this.
We've won it now, or we will do.
It's buttoned.
I'm talking about me, eh?
Jerome thinks I should take the money.
And so do I.
I'm not going to.
Why not?
Because it's immoral.
Nikki, you're skint.
So what?
And you need it.
Look, I'm in work at 6:30. I'll catch you later.
See you later. Me needing it or not doesn't even come into it. I know how you and Tim got that money. And of course, I'm not going to go and tell on you because I love you. That doesn't mean I've got to accept it.
Well, at least take 500 then, just to see you through.
Oh, you just don't get it, do you?
Get what?
The morality of it. Somewhere along the line, someone is out of pocket.
Yeah, those robbers.
And where do you think they got it from?
I don't know. Who cares?
Me? Okay, put it another way. Say me nan had a purse robbed and there was £100 in it.
Yeah.
And the people who robbed it gave Tim £50 out of it.
I know what you're going to say.
And then Tim gave you £30 out of it and you found out where it came from, right?
Right.
Now, would you say that was moral or immoral?
Immoral.
Thank you. Hi, love. Everything OK?
Any problems, sir?
What's that?
The ball hit me in the face.
What ball?
He did it in the games lesson.
Oh?
You were playing football?
Yeah.
That's great. Did you score?
Oh, no, I wasn't going.
Go away. That was my best position when I was in school.
Hey, it's great to hear you playing with the other kids.
The teacher said he had to.
John Wilson never had a goalie, so I had to go and go for them.
At least he got picked.
That was only because he never had even numbers. And Thomas Ross hit the ball as hard as he could in my face. Everyone started laughing. Now I've got homework to do. Going upstairs.
You love that tent, don't you?
Yeah, they'd sleep in there if they could. Aren't you going to work?
No, not tonight.
You've got an hour?
Yeah, and I'm giving you an hour to get yourself ready.
What for?
Your present. I've arranged a Valentine's night out for me and you.
Great. Do you mind, Jack? I know we had plans, but no. Oh, what about Beth?
Well, that's all sorted. Jessie's minding her.
Poor Jessie's gone out. Said she won't be back until later.
Oh, are you joking?
No, honest.
Oh, great. That's my first night off for weeks. I'm going to end up stuck in.
She wants to forget.
You know what? You wouldn't believe the trouble I've had trying to get tonight off as well.
Mike, there's nothing we can do about it.
The whole night's ruined.
Well, why don't we get a few cans and then we can all sit in?
Oh, it's not the same, is it?
I suppose not.
Do you know what, Rachel? I've really been looking forward to tonight. We haven't had a night out in ages, have we?
Oh, no.
And I wouldn't know who else to ask.
Well, Jessie might come back yet.
Do you know what? I just feel like putting my uniform on and going into work. I've lost out all round.
I'll watch it if you want.
Do you know what, Jack? I thought you'd never ask.
Are you sure you don't mind?
No.
Cheers, sis.
Thanks.
Are you not playing, Jess?
Jerome, will you sit down a minute? Is our Nicky told you about Ray and Helen? So what do you think?
I think it's cool.
You don't think it's all a bit sudden?
Helen's sad.
You don't think there's any ulterior motive?
Jessie, Helen's all right.
Well, what do you think of Ray's carryings on? I mean, he did cheat on his wife, don't forget.
He was a lot younger than Jess.
Is that why you cheated on our Nicky? Because you're young?
Oh, hey, Jessie.
Well, I'm not getting at you. I'm just trying to see what's going on in Ray's head. I feel as if I don't know him anymore.
I was like that with Nicky.
So why did you cheat on her?
I was under a lot of pressure at the time.
How were you under pressure?
Well, everybody knew about Nicky getting raped, didn't they?
Yeah.
Well, it got to the stage where I was just sick of hearing the word rape. But I couldn't tell Nicky that, could I? I mean, I had to fight a corner. I had to be there for her all the time, answering all the questions over what had happened to her. I had to hold it all inside of me. It got to the point where I was having one-to-one sessions with her in my head, trying to find out how she was, trying to fathom how she was doing.
So why did you go with that Nisha one? I thought you were devoted to Nicky.
I was. Oh, I am. Jesse, I love Nicky, you know.
I know that. And I'm sorry to be asking all these questions. But I don't know who else to ask.
Being with Nicky was hard, Jess. I'm telling you. But being with Nisha, well, it made me feel great again. I mean, I'd come home from work and I'd see Nicky sitting there and it was like I had this big weight on my shoulders and I couldn't shrug it off. Do I sound like a real selfish git?
Yes, you do. But I think people are like that.
There you go, you romantic couple, you. Man, that plate is hot. Ow.
Cheers, Jim.
There you go, straight from the microwave. Not so much a la carte as a la carton.
How come we're the only ones in?
Yeah, don't know about that. Thought this place would have been booming.
Yeah, so did I.
Most people are going to the shelf. Yeah, we've had about 10 inquiries, you know. People asking where it is. Anyway, bon appetito.
Has he forgotten what he did to me? Drawing me dad's outline on the patio.
Looks like, don't it? But then that's Jimmy Corkle for you. Who knows what goes on inside his head?
Oh, I feel dead sorry for him.
Yeah, it's a sad opening, isn't it?
Mm-hmm. Looks like we're going to be on our own all night.
Well, that's the way I planned it, actually. I want to be on my own with the best babe in the world.
Thanks, Mike.
I mean it, you know, Rach.
Getting quite used to this, being on our own.
Do you feel exclusive?
Yeah, I hope it stays like this.
Yeah, so do I.
Oh, no. Another customer going to spoil our party.
Nope, oh, he's gone.
Yes.
Get in there.
I'm really enjoying this.
Yeah, so am I.
Mike, I didn't want to ask, but where are you getting the money from for all this?
Well, for once, Rachel, I thought, sod it. We can catch up on the bills.
Do you think so?
Yeah, no problem. And I'm working, aren't I? And don't you think we deserve a night out together?
Yeah.
So long as we're together, I don't care.
Me neither.
Forever.
Hello? Oh, Mrs. Symes. What a coincidence. As a matter of fact, I'm just going over the Great Granny's books now. But she didn't turn up today. I am really sorry about that. Could you just remind me again who your cleaner is? Yes, I do know my staff. It's just that we swap them round every so often. Jessie. Well, once again, I can only apologise and promise you that I will have words with her first thing in the morning. And I can assure you that she will definitely, definitely be there next week. OK, thank you. Bye.
Helen? Oh, hiya. Are you playing?
No, not tonight.
Oh, why not?
I wanted to talk to you.
Right.
What's going on?
Sorry?
Didn't you realise the impact you turning up would have on our lives?
Well, of course I did.
So why?
Why what?
Why pick this moment in time to find him?
I wasn't looking for him. He just appeared here, if you remember.
Oh, I remember only too well.
Jessie, have you got a problem with me?
Yes, I have, actually. Our lives have been turned upside down. Ray's beside himself at the moment. That's how he set the bungalow on fire.
And you're saying that's all down to me?
You're the one with all the choices here. You didn't have to show yourself to Ray.
Oh, hold on. I didn't ask for Ray to be my dad. Where's the choice in that?
You could have walked away.
Yeah, but I didn't, did I? This has been as much a shock for me, you know.
Yes, I'm sure it has. But since we met you, we've had nothing but bad luck.
That's not my fault.
We've lost everything. Home, money.
Look, I know. And I'm really sorry about that.
Yeah, I bet you are.
What does that mean?
Well, Ray won't be able to help you out now, will he?
Help me out?
He hasn't got a penny to his name.
You think I'm only after money?
I don't know. You tell me.
Have you seen Jessie?
Oh, yeah.
Well, she's not inside and I'm a lift home.
She's not been playing bingo.
She hasn't?
Oh, no. She's been having a go at me.
What about?
She seems to think I'm some kind of gold digger.
You what?
She's accused me of wanting to get money off Ray.
Look, pay no attention to her. She's up the wall at the minute.
Yeah, I imagine she is. I don't want people thinking that's why I got in touch.
Well, they won't.
Ray might.
No way.
Maybe Jessie's right. Maybe I have been selfish.
What are you saying?
Perhaps I didn't think hard enough about it. I just didn't stop and really think it through. The effect it'd have on everybody.
Look, Helen, don't start all that.
I'm not starting. I'm finishing. So do us a favour, will you, Jerome?
What?
When you see Ray, will you tell him it was nice meeting him? I really want to keep our lives separate from now on.
Well, Helen, you can't do that.
Oh, I can. So tell him not to get in touch, because I certainly won't.
Aye, and after here we come.
What if Max comes home early?
Are we going to go topless?
It can be put right.
How can it be when Helen won't even talk to me?
I'm hardly England's most eligible, am I?
I think I've got a lot to offer you.
She's my daughter,
and she's muscling in on our family.
Suppose if one does, then we all should.
Inappropriate behaviour. People get unnerved.
That's tomorrow at 8:30. Next tonight, doctors caring for elderly stroke victims who are critically ill face the dilemma of when to continue treatment and when to allow them to die. The Trust, coming up.
The bingo of Dr. Pay for being your bow tie. What's up with you then?
I'm just sick of playing piggy in the middle, that's all. Look, I wasn't going to say anything, but Helen collared me last night after your nan had given her the third degree.
Cool.
Well, your nan reckons that Helen's being dead selfish, just barging in, not caring what she was doing to Ray. She sent her on a real guilt trip and then made out she was only in it for the money. Well, she reckons it's best if she doesn't see him anymore. Best all round.
What?
Hang on, let me just... Are we sorted? Who went to book it in the end? Michelle, go.
Me, her and Stacey. It's all booked in Stacey's name.
Can you believe it?
25 down, only another £545 to go.
How many shifts of the garage is that?
Don't think about it.
Oh, I don't care. Iron Apper, here we come. 5 beaches.
12 clubs.
Over 150 bars. And no mobiles. Might get a decent conversation out of you at last.
Joking, aren't you? It's Joe Bandness. I can use it worldwide.
Quiz night? Yeah, boring. Middle-aged men in V-necks. Yeah, plus you need a quiz.
School is nice. Everyone has to dress up as a schoolgirl.
Might as well call it Pervs Night and be done with it.
Beth, what are you on about?
Oh, I need to get people here, Jimmy. I want to put an ad in the Echo, you know, get the punters rolling back, but you need an angle, don't you?
Oh, an angle, yeah. Friendly atmosphere.
More atmosphere on Mars. I mean, shy night. For antisocial gets who won't speak to one another.
I know, steady on.
Well, look at them. Then they could at least punch together and make the place sound busy.
Well, you know what they say. Three's a crowd.
Yeah, but crowds is what I need. Oh, I am so depressed. No offence.
Oh, none taken.
What am I going to do, Jimmy? I mean, I took £30 last night. Someone broke the hand dryer in the ladies. That's a 50 quid call I'll charge before you blink.
Yeah. Well, it takes time for word to get round, you know.
Yeah, but have we got time? I mean, there's a new bar open by the Chippy. The Swan's been done up, but maybe there's just not enough drinkers to go round.
In Liverpool?
I'm telling you, Jimmy, if this place goes under, I am finished.
Hey, fancy scuba diving? Hey, listen to this. Moonlight madness. Crazy keepers on the sand, all lit by moonlight. And a 3-hour free bar.
Count me in.
Plus, a belly-busting barbecue. Don't forget your cozy or your camera, a night you won't forget.
Anyone home?
In here.
Right. Where's your mum?
Bath. She'll be down soon.
Don't say I never give you anything.
Cheers.
Oi.
Oh, Dad.
And, no belching while we're trying to watch the weepy bits. What's that?
That'll be Stacey about the
homework. That essay. Biology.
Oh, yeah. Do you think your nan was right? Do you think they will go after Eds?
I don't know.
At least he's in a good mood, though. Are you going to tell them tonight?
I'll wait till he's had a few beers.
And I've gone home, I hope. Mind you, if I was here, your mum might not kick off. Would she?
If my mum's going to kick off, she kicks off. She doesn't do embarrassment. Who is it?
Stacey. Are we going to go topless?
I hadn't really thought about it. Are you?
Don't know. I suppose if one does, then we all should. I'll ask Michelle.
Hey, this is a nice surprise. Thought it was just going to be me and the telly again.
Yeah, well, Jessie's got a guilty conscience after last night.
And you're going to milk it?
Too right. She made a steak and kidney pie for tea. She's done a pile of ironing this eye and now she's minding Beth. She should let us down more often.
So, how was your romantic night out?
Very exclusive. We had the place to ourselves.
On Valentine's?
Yeah, apart from people nipping into us directions to the shelf. It was a bit embarrassing for Bev, but it was brilliant for us. Like something out of the movies. So what about you? Breakfast in bed and a bunch of red roses, I bet. You lucky cow.
Yeah, I wish. I got Maxo's designer cufflinks, and he got me a card from the garage and leftovers. In fact, you can have this cake now with a cup of coffee.
I can't eat that.
Not slimming, are you?
No, but what if Max comes home early? He's probably planning some posh meal and that's for afters.
Do you reckon?
Yeah, or that's the meal and you're the afters. You don't know what he's got in his mind. And this is Max we're talking about. And it's your first Valentine's. If nothing else, the cufflinks will have shamed him into splashing out.
Well, I didn't give them to him. I had a cob on.
Going early tonight, Laura?
Yeah, I'm staying at my mum's tonight. She's picking me up at the end of the close.
Have a nice time, then.
OK, see ya.
I'll call you.
Tell you if I had one round or two for my breakfast.
Anyone want another drink? Another beer, Dad?
Don't mind.
Nothing for me, love. No. Look at Dozy Draws. Has she lost something?
Oh. They're all like that. Once the bell goes, zombie generation. Except this one.
What's that?
I'm just saying, thank God you're normal. At least you can string a few words together without having to have a machine to do it for you.
I won't be saying that when the phone bill comes in.
I'm not a bad one, am I, Dad? I pay my way.
Kind of.
Anyway, I'll be glad of that job come July. I'm going away with a few of the girls from school. Fortnight, I and Appa.
Shouldn't you be somewhere else?
Hey, what have I forgotten now?
Like down the bingo, apologising to Helen. What were you thinking of, Nan? Why can't she get to know her own father?
I'm not stopping her.
Well, why make out that Helen's being selfish? Why can't you just be happy for the both of them?
I'm thinking of Ray. Does he look happy to you?
Nan, you're making it hard for him.
Well, I'm trying to protect him, that's all. She expects too much after all this time.
Nan, she doesn't want his money.
Who said anything about money?
You did. You practically called her a gold digger.
Well, you're just twisting things now. I mean, if we talked about money, it was only because of...
Whose money? What have you done, Jess?
Just girls.
Don't take me to the butchers.
You what?
Why would we want to take lads with us?
I don't mean lads. I mean just girls, no parents.
Well, you're not on, is she, Mart?
16 years old. No chance.
Loads of people go away at my age.
Away, maybe. Not abroad.
Yeah. In sixth form, everyone goes.
Everyone.
Don't be so literal.
Hey.
No one else's mum and dad have complained.
Do you think we're soft?
Stacey's getting the holiday for her birthday present.
And what about the others? Shall I ring their parents? Michelle's mum.
If you want to make a show of yourself.
If you're trying to get round us, you've got a funny way of showing it. Di, put the phone down. You're not ringing anyone, because she's not going. Next year, maybe.
I don't want to go next year.
Tough.
Ooh, that's constructive.
Sorry, Del, that's my final say.
Tough. I've already paid my deposit. I'm going, whether you like it or not.
It's a horrible misunderstanding, that's all. It can be put right.
How can it be when Helen won't even talk to me?
I'll go and see her. Explain she's got me all wrong.
You shouldn't have gone round there in the first place.
Hiya. Oh.
Hello, love. Not a peep.
Good. Excuse me.
That was a sly trick, sloping off behind me back.
I wasn't sloping off. I happened to be at the bingo. She happened to be at work.
Oh, convenient.
You make it sound like some great plot. It wasn't. I just wanted to speak to the girl. I just wanted to know...
What? What more did you want to know? I mean, don't you trust what I've already told you?
Well, now you come to mention it, no. It's hardly been a full and frank account, has it?
Oh.
Nice one, Nan.
Ray!
You didn't think to ask us first, so you knew you were in the wrong.
I knew what you'd be like.
I wish I had money to burn.
Whatever.
How long have you been planning this?
Long enough.
Can't you see what it looks like, Del? One minute you're sneaking round like a school kid with a naughty secret, and the next you're making out you're all mature and independent.
Fat chance of that with you two around.
Look, we're not trying to stop your fun.
You'll be holding my hand crossing the road next.
There's no talking to her when she's in this mood.
When I'm in the right, I stick to me guns. That's a good thing, isn't it?
When you're in the right?
Yeah, we used our initiative to make the booking. We worked extra shifts to pay for it. Most of us.
It's not about the money.
You should be proud I'm standing on my own 2 feet.
It's too soon. You're not ready.
You don't trust me.
It's not that.
No, I don't. We don't. We don't trust your judgment. You let people take advantage of you.
You think I'm going to come back pregnant?
You don't know what these resorts are like. People get carried away.
Because that's what I want. A string of abortions by the time I'm 20. Because I'm sex mad, aren't I?
No, you're not. You're just unlucky.
You can say that again. Got you two as my mum and dad.
I'm sorry. I could bite my tongue off.
I don't want to talk to you.
I wasn't saying that you'd lied to me. What I meant was I've had to tease things out of you a bit at a time.
Yeah, do you wonder why? You take over, Jess. You've always got to be the boss.
I don't.
This is between me and Helen.
Well, no, it isn't, actually.
She's my daughter.
And she's muscling in on our family.
There you go again. Muscling in. Don't you think that makes her feel hostile?
I wasn't hostile when we were inviting around for lunch, was I? I wasn't hostile when we were sitting around making small talk, when I overheard you had a granddaughter.
You just keep on to it from now on.
That's easy for you to say.
Can you keep your voices down?
Sorry.
Do you mind?
I mean it. Keep your nose out. You've done enough damage already.
Isn't just one long orgy. No one's saying that, Del. Will you listen? You'd be away from home. You'd be meeting people...
Fellas.
A few years older than you. People with more confidence. People who can hold a drink.
So I'm an alcoholic as well now, am I?
It's easy to have a drop too much. We've all done it. That's when things start to go wrong. You can get your bag robbed. You can cop off with the wrong person. You can get into a fight.
It's on the bright side, eh?
You'd have no one to turn to if something did happen. And I wouldn't sleep a wink for worrying.
So that's why I can't go? Because you care more than anyone else's mum?
No.
That's not what she said.
Because you don't. Not from where I'm standing. And I'll tell you something else. You wouldn't have stopped our Steve from going.
Thanks, love. So, 6 months in Mio. Must have been homesick.
You can't get a decent butty in Brazil. The bread is terrible. That's sweet. You know what? I used to dream about big, thick, crusty toast dripping in butter.
Mm.
I'd wake up, I could almost taste it. Did you ever do that?
Well, I stopped dreaming when I was on the tablets.
What, you mean stop remembering them?
No, just stopped. It's the opposite now. It's as if my brain's in overdrive.
What? Oh, sorry. Did I miss much?
Nah.
You're not in the mood?
I was just thinking.
I hate it when you think.
We're not being too hard on you, you know.
I know we're not.
And that thing she said about Steve, about us treating him differently.
It was right.
She thinks I'm rubbing her nose in it about the abortion, but I'm not. Hand on heart, I'm not.
No need to tell me.
I wouldn't have let her go away anyway. If she'd never got pregnant, I would have thought she was too innocent.
Hmm.
I just wish you'd picked a better time to ask. That we could have said yes. Just to, you know, spread a bit of good news for a change. Be like we were making one of them happy at least.
Come here. We are good parents. We do right by them kids.
Well, they'd rather we put a smile on their faces.
Well.
Don't you ever think sometimes we're not bad people? Why us? We deserve a break.
That iron up is nice this time of year.
Hey, shall I run you to bath?
Mm. Great.
Scrub your back if you like, seeing as you didn't get the chance on Valentine's.
You know, actually, I think I'll just have a shower and hit the hay. Oh! Absolutely shattered.
Can I tempt you?
Oh, no, thanks.
Don't worry. I won't get all drunk and maudlin on you. Nothing worse, is there, when you're sober?
Well...
used to be drunks in here once.
Help me back. Do you mind if I say something? You've lost your spark.
Tell me about it.
And it's not because of worrying about the bar. I thought Rio would have been your place, you know. Your sorts of people.
You know.
So wasn't it all wild and wonderful?
Times.
What?
Well, went around the beach, did a bit of shopping, went to dance. And the thing with me, Jimmy, I get on with things. I live in the here and now.
Oh, carpe diem.
Thought that was a cocktail.
Latin. Seize the day. Live each one as if it's your last. That's it, isn't it? You left your heart with some Copacabana beach bum.
I drifted. I mean, I passed the time, but that's different, isn't it? I met people, but didn't connect.
So you're not sorry that you came back?
Funny when you're away, isn't it? I mean, you wander down streets and you look in people's windows and everyone seems to have dead busy lives and be from big families and they're always snogging Brazilians. On the street, on the bus, anywhere. When you're on your own, it feels like everywhere. And all you wish is someone you loved was round the corner, waiting to put their arms round you.
So you did feel homesick?
I feel that when I'm at home.
So, come on, I've seen me cake. Where's the rest of it?
Sorry?
Me Valentine's treat.
Oh, your cake was it.
Are you serious?
Well, I got you a card, didn't I?
Yeah, but...
Ah, unless you want your car to be this year's present and your skiing trip the next.
Oh, right, so it's like that, is it?
Well, how else should it be?
Well, I just thought we might get a chance to do something special together.
We do. Most of the time. More than most couples we know.
Yeah, we're very lucky.
Jackie, I adore you, you know that, and I don't need any cynical greetings card company to tell me when to say it.
I know. And I'm sorry, I've just been talking rubbish. Anyway, I got you these.
I should have given to you yesterday. But, well, anyway, these are with all my love.
Jackie? Thanks, they're great.
But, you know, maybe I should just take them back.
No, 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 they're perfect.
But it was some cynical greeting card company that gave me the idea to buy them.
Do you ever get that feeling, Jimmy? If it didn't fit? Ask a stupid question. No, I did think Rio might be different, but, you know, the eternal optimist, the eternal desperado.
Eh?
Mm. With me, though, I don't think it's places. I just don't fit in with what's going on anymore. I mean, everyone wants to be so cool. What's that all about? No, I'm serious. I mean, what is the point? You meet a fella, you fall head over heels, and you can't say anything because it's not cool.
Oh, well. Passion's out, right?
Big time. I mean, fellas now, they won't let the guard down. They won't even crease the designer kecks for you. Just can't be yourself.
Oh, well. They say youth is wasted on the young. I say young women are wasted on young men.
Is there a compliment in there somewhere?
Well, Bev, you're a young woman.
Wait when I'll get like you, I am.
Thanks. See, still the eternal optimist. Now, people have always had to do it, you know. Pretend. Because they're scared.
Bet you were a swine.
Oh, when I was a young buck. I thrived, don't I? No, don't turn up on time. Don't turn up at all sometimes. Keep them guessing. You'd have liked me then. It's dangerous. Yeah, come on, say. I'm dangerous now. That's different, though.
I wasn't going to say that. It's still Jimmy Corkill. What?
I wonder sometimes. I ended up on a roof in odd shoes. How cool is that?
Do you want me to turn this off?
No. Why?
Well, you're up and down like a fiddler's elbow.
Oh, I'm sorry. Am I putting you off? I'm sorry.
Is it Ray?
Jerome.
Oh, don't bang the door.
They say age is just a number, but it's not to me. I'm lonely, Jimmy. And it's the sort of thing you say with shame, and the older I get, the lonelier I feel.
Yeah, you can be lonely in a big family. You can be lonely in a marriage. I know that for a fact.
Shatter all my fantasies, why don't you? So, what about you?
Me? Well, I suppose I've just accepted this is me.
What?
On my own. Divorced, bipolar pop man with no discernible assets. I'm hardly England's most eligible, am I?
I think I've got a lot to offer, Jim.
I wasn't fishing for compliments.
I know you weren't. You haven't got much of an ego, have you?
No, not now. I used to have. I miss that. On the tablets.
What was that like?
Safe.
Safe's good sometimes.
You don't mean that. On the tablets. I wouldn't have noticed your perfume.
Not wearing any.
Apple.
Conditioner.
Wouldn't have noticed the sheen on your hair. When it's almost gold. Wouldn't have wanted to touch it.
And do you want to touch it?
Inappropriate behaviour. People get unnerved. Pineapple.
Was that inappropriate behaviour?
I don't know.
Seize the day, Jimmy.
Jay, that's the third time you've been in there. What you're after?
Paracetamol. Paracetamol and earplugs.
There you go. What's up with you?
Yeah, it's banging. There was a kick-off today over a claim on the National. Two of the hard ones nearly got into a fight.
It wasn't Bridget, was it?
Then I get home and a marriage guidance counsellor and taxi driver all rolled into one.
Are you right, Jerome?
I'm coming. She collared me before. She wants me to drive around in case Ray's wandering the street somewhere.
Mm. Is it open?
Are you now?
I'll be with you now, Jess.
You don't mind, do you, love? We won't be long.
I swear, I prefer it when she hated me guts.
Don't let go. It's been a long time.
I wasn't going to.
Don't come upstairs with me now.
No.
You keep me guessing, Jimmy.
No.
Don't play it cool.
I couldn't. Not with you.
Then come upstairs with me now.
No, you're not going anywhere.
Door's open.
I know.
Well, someone might come in.
I know.
This is so cool.
Hang on a sec, so you're saying you got your end away?
Not exactly the phrase I would have used, but seems as you're all so interested. Yes.
What are you doing?
Will you listen to yourself? You sound like a right sulky.
Hey, come on, you can't deny what we are going in here.
I can and I am.
Why are you arresting me? I haven't even done anything. You're supposed to be a free country.
And that's on Wednesday at 8. Next, it's The Holiday from Hell with Father Ted.
Mmm, smell that bacon. Best smell in the world, that.
What's he on?
That's a problem. He's not on anything.
Hiya, Nick!
Morning, Jim. You're in a good mood.
No, I'm not. I'm in a great mood. In fact, this is the best I've felt for as long as I can remember.
How come?
Wouldn't have anything to do with you not coming home till the early hours, would it, you dirty stop out?
My lips are sealed.
You're not telling us that you got lucky, are you?
Hang on a sec. You're saying you got your end away?
Not exactly the phrase I would have used, but seems as you're all so interested, yes.
And?
Nothing.
Oh, come on, Jimmy, you can't leave it at that. Who was she?
A gentleman never tells. But put it this way, I'm not the only one round here with a smile on the face this morning.
Hiya. What is it with these two and having to drag every single toy out of the box?
Here, I'll give you a hand.
Are you thinking keep an eye on them for me later?
Sure, no problem. Well, I'll take them out if you like. Have the house to yourself for a few hours.
Oh, no, you don't have to. I'm going to go round to Katie's.
What's the occasion?
Well, it's a birthday and I don't want her to think that I've forgotten.
All right.
Because it doesn't do to forget special occasions, does it?
Like I forgot Valentine's Day.
You said it, not me.
I'll make it up to you.
You'd already are by taking these two off my hands.
I mean properly.
Oh, yeah?
Tonight, just you and me, I'm going to cook us an unforgettable meal.
We'll have the time.
I'll make the time. So, what time are you heading off to Katie's?
Post 11, if that's okay with you.
Yeah. Won't she be at work?
Well, no. I phoned Nisha at the centre and she said she's taking the day off. Do you know what? I'm a bit worried about her, to be honest.
Well, I thought you'd got over a rough patch.
Yeah, so did I. But Nisha says she was out of it this morning. You know, a little bit down.
Well, no one likes racking up another year.
I think there's a bit more to it than that.
Do you know what the best thing about half-term is?
Having you at home, getting under my feet.
Don't worry, I'm going in tomorrow. No, the best thing about half-term is not having to deal with teenagers. The noise, the mess, the chaos that descends everywhere they go.
I'll get that, shall I?
If only schools didn't have teenagers in them, they'd be perfect.
Come in, love. Adele, Laura's here.
I'm upstairs.
I know that. Can you come down, please? Do you communicate with your mum?
Only when I have to.
So it's not just me, then? I thought it might be the gas man.
No such luck.
You weren't planning on going out, were you? Only told them there'd be somebody in.
What time?
Well, they never say, do they?
Oh, great, so I'm stuck here all day.
Can you give me a hand?
Hiya, Steve.
All right.
I'm reading.
Oh, come on. I only took this car on today because I knew you'd be at home to give me a hand.
Oh, did you now?
What's the big deal?
Okay.
Oi!
It's not as if we've got anything else to do now. Come on, then.
So, are you going on this so-called trip to Iron Appa?
Yeah.
There's loads going, isn't there?
Yeah, everyone.
So who's everyone? Because so far the only name Adele's mentioned is yours.
Oh, you know.
No, I don't. That's why I'm asking.
Mum, you're embarrassing Laura.
Well, if you won't tell me what's going on, what do you expect? So your mum's okay with you going?
You haven't spoken to her, have you?
No, it's just I'm only asking because according to Adele, we're Victorian throwbacks or something.
Oh, no, but she's sound about it.
Must be just us, then. Being overprotective.
Come on, let's go to my room. She reckons she's Anne Robinson. Thinks we'll crack under pressure.
What are you lined up for today, Ken?
Type a few loose ends, you know.
Finish selling that knock-off ale, more like.
Hey?
You think we're blind or something? We know what you get up to.
Yeah, well, it's all right for you too, swanning around being students. I've got to make a living.
Give me a break. We've got jobs as well. Anyway, I'm not sure whether I'm going to be a student for much longer.
What's that?
Thinking of packing it in.
What for? You love doing that course, don't you?
It's not because it's a problem. It's paying for it.
Yeah, well, you wouldn't have a problem if you'd taken the money from Em.
Yeah, and we all know where she got it from.
Well, then, let's go down to uni, get yourself sorted with an application for a hardship grant. I mean, with the fire and everything, they're bound to give you something.
Yeah, I suppose it's worth a try. It still doesn't get me past having a load of debt, though. I mean, if I go straight through, I'm going to be spending the next 10 years paying it all off. And that's only if I go through. Can give out as many loans as they like, but what's the point? People don't have the money to finish the course.
Nikki, I know it's difficult, but don't you think you're taking the easy way out?
Easy? You must be joking.
All I'm saying is that degree is your passport to better things. There's no other route. And believe me, I'm the past master of trying to cut corners.
Jimmy, I know what you're saying, and I would love to be able to finish my course, but I don't want to shackle myself to a mountain of debt for the rest of me natural.
All I'm saying then is think about it. Education, it's big, life-changing stuff. You don't want to throw it away at the drop of a hat. Look, you think you'll go back to it when you've got a few bob, but it's not that easy. You get used to not being brassic all the time. Then you get settled, married, kids come along, and before you know it, life's happened, and all the plans you had have gone.
Right, turn it over.
I'm amazed this thing's worth repairing.
Okay. You can turn it off now.
All right. Right.
Yeah. Good sound.
Yeah, you can give him an hand. I'm supposed to be having the day off.
Oh, no rest for the wicked, eh?
Oh, I don't know about that. Some people seem to get by without doing a turn.
Ignore him. He's just got a cob on because Ardell wants to go to Iron Appa.
Yeah, well, I can't blame him. They get up to all sorts there. I've always fancied it myself. If I wasn't married, that is.
So what's up?
Well, I got rid of the last of the ale. That's what's up.
I thought we'd still be carting that round the pubs this time next year.
Until I bumped into me old mate.
Oh, aye. One of your dodgy mates. Hope he paid you.
No, there's nothing dodgy about him. He's getting hitched, so we took it all for his reception. I'm telling you, he needs some serious beer goggles and all. The girl he's marrying. She's a right minger.
So we took the whole lot?
Every last bit. There you go.
Morning, boss. Sorry I'm late.
Don't worry about it.
Bet you said that to all your pot men.
Jimmy.
Yeah?
About last night.
Cool, wasn't it? I mean, you know someone, you work with them, you never think of them in that way, and then something magic happens, you know, something neither of you'd expected, and pow! Changes your life. I mean, I'm surprised there wasn't another fire, you know, man, the sparks flying here last night.
Yeah, well, I had had a few.
Well, you can't put it down to drink, you know.
Well, maybe there was a bit more to it than that.
A lot more.
Jimmy, I like you. I really do. And, well, let's face it, we've both been through the mill lately.
Hey, two lost souls who found each other.
I want to let you down gently.
Let me down.
Look, Jimmy, last night was a one-off, OK?
Hey, come on, you can't deny what we had going in here.
I can and I am. I don't want to sound half-faced, but, well, you and me, we're a non-starter, aren't we? And I just wanted to let you know before you got any ideas.
Well, can't we at least talk about it?
Sorry, Jim, but last night, it never happened, OK?
Another 200 quid,
yeah? Yeah, well, I got a decent price from my arm, mate. Easy money.
Yeah, well, it wasn't that easy when we were humping bottles around every pub in town.
Yeah, but it's worth it at the end of the day, though, isn't it?
Yeah. Beats working in some poxy car dealership for some tosser in a suit, I suppose.
Hey, you better put that away. Well, you are, Felicis.
Yeah, nice one.
So, should I give you a shout when the next job turns up?
I thought I'd told you. My days of crime are over.
Behave.
I mean it. It was a one-off.
Are you sure?
Look, I'm sorry, Tim. I only helped you out because you couldn't find anyone.
I can't believe this. You're turning down big money here.
Yeah, it was big because we didn't get caught. Doesn't look so attractive if, you know, some head case gives you a hiding or the busy stick you in Walton.
Yeah, and that's only if you get caught. But that's not part of the plan.
Well, prisons are full of people that didn't have getting caught as part of the plan.
Yeah, I know that. But it's like any job, isn't it? You run the risk so you can get the rewards.
Yeah, so you're going to do this again then?
Yeah, of course. Only this time it's going to be bigger. And something which is easier to shift.
Like what? Have
to just wait and see.
I don't know about this, Jay.
What's the problem? I mean, they've got money for people who are skint. And anyway, nobody said that this was going to be easy.
I just don't like having to beg for what should be mine.
You're not begging.
I don't know, but when you apply for a hardship grant, well, look through all your bank statements and everything. For what? A measly few hundred quid. Ah, oh, what's going on?
I don't know. Sorry, I'm surprised. Come ahead, Nick. Let's go.
No, hang on a sec. Let's see what's going on. Katie! Katie! Lunch on the table. Only haven't got long.
I forgot. I'll do you the butty now.
Oh, I don't believe you sometimes.
In helping Steve do one of his foreigners, I've only just this minute sat down.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to snap at you.
The day off this is. I was hoping to stay away from teenagers, not to spend the afternoon with a house full of them. That Tim fella came round early to see our Steve.
They seem to be hanging out together a lot lately.
Yeah, they do, don't they?
Still, you can't run the lights for them, can you? Not all the time, anyway. Have they surfaced yet?
Probably still planning that holiday.
I was thinking of giving Laura's mum a ring, but that might make things 10 times worse.
Yeah, well, you know what Adele's like. If you tell her not to do something, she just stick her heels in.
Okay, I'll tell you what. I'll bet we're not the only parents that are unhappy about this. Why do we let somebody else do the dirty work for a change?
They'll soon start dropping out.
Do you think?
Yeah, I'm telling you. They'll have forgotten all about it this time next week.
Oh, I hope you're right. Because I don't think I've got the energy to do another battle with Adele.
I'm telling you, be fine.
All right, I'm coming.
Katie, what are you playing at?
What do you mean?
Well, I've been pressing the buzzer for the past 20 minutes. And if it hadn't been for Bev popping back up to the flat, I'd still be waiting down there.
Sorry.
You been drinking?
Well, I've had to have a drink on my birthday.
On your own, first thing in the morning, I think you know the answer to that.
Well, I feel rotten.
Yeah, well, you don't look too clever either.
Do you want one? Misery loves company, you know.
No, I'm going to make us a coffee. And then you can tell me what all this is about.
Some government ministers visiting the uni. We're going to give them a hard time while trying to reinstate student grants.
Ah, that must be why there's all those busies.
So is your curiosity satisfied?
I suppose.
Good.
Jay, where are you going?
Well, you said you wanted to know what was going on. Well, now you do.
I'm staying.
Why? It's not like anyone's going to listen. Can't we just go home and go back to bed?
Jay, it's the middle of the afternoon.
Exactly.
You've been listening to me the past few months. I might be having to drop out because some accountant down in London thought they could save a few bob by making us pay fees.
Nikki, what's the point? Nobody ever listens. And anyway, we could get our own tucked up in bed.
Don't be soft. You're not allowed to protest. Anyway, why do you think people like us were able to go to uni in the first place? It's because people kicked off. Let those in power know that education should be for everyone. Just a few toffee-nosed public schoolies whose mummy and daddy can afford to pay them through.
Yeah, all right then, I'll stay with you. But after that, we're going to bed, all right?
Come on, take it.
No, look, I really appreciate it. You can't go giving everything you make to me and your dad.
I don't mind.
And that 500 you gave me, you'll get that back, you know.
Don't worry about it. I only hope it works this time.
Oh, there's no guarantees, but at least it gives us a chance.
Look, I said I'd help when I meant it.
Enough, Steve. Anyway, how come you've got so much spare cash these days?
Like I said, you know, been doing okay. Little jobs here and there, all adds up.
You need to keep some back for yourself. It's not right, a lad your age handing over all his money to his parents. You should be out enjoying yourself.
I am. I mean, but I have been.
With that O'Leary lad.
Well, he's a myth.
Just watch him, though. He's not someone who makes his money through honest graft like you.
Don't worry, he's just a myth.
Set that down, Adele.
What's that?
Oh, housekeeping. Steve was just giving me some housekeeping money.
Maybe your name was right. Medicals do that.
Funny.
Any lunch going?
Why don't you try the kitchen?
Okay.
Just let me know what you've had when you've finished. I'll make up your bill.
What?
Oh, I'm sorry. Did I miss you the other day? I thought you were going to pay your own way from now on. You know, stand on your own 2 feet.
You're going to make me pay for my food?
You see, it's not your food. Me and your mum paid for it.
Yeah, but what about our Steve?
He pays his share.
But I'm still at school. You can't expect me to pay my own keep. Come on, Laura.
You've got a job.
That money's to pay for my holiday.
You can't pick and choose when you want people to treat you like an adult, can't you, Laura?
No, Mr. Murray.
You know what your problem is?
Well, go on, enlighten me.
You don't want to see me enjoy myself just because you're past it?
Nick, can't we stand back a little bit?
Like wind, shocker.
The legs back home in bed.
Hey, what do you think my name is? Yoko. Anyway, we'll be able to see if we're back here. Hey, Jake, we might be on the telly.
Somehow, I don't think so.
What's he doing then?
He's playing with that lad there. Special branch or something.
Well, what would they be wanting? Filming a bunch of students?
In case there's trouble.
What?
Yeah.
Is this for you?
Grants of peace!
There you go, black coffee with 2 sugars. And you're lecturing me? What are you doing?
Well, you listen to yourself. You sound like a rice alky.
It's not even mine.
Well, I couldn't care less whose it is. I'd have your Sammy town for getting paralytic first thing in the morning, but not you.
It's my birthday.
Oh, right, you were celebrating.
Not exactly.
Do you want to tell me what all this is about, then?
You know.
Clint. You think I'm a right sad case, don't you? It was a year ago.
Doesn't mean you're gonna stop thinking about him.
I can go hours, a whole day sometimes. I don't think about him once. And then when I'm doing something daft, like washing the dishes or listening to the radio, it all comes flopping back. I keep telling myself I need to move on, but I can't.
Grief doesn't go in nice, neat boxes that you can put away and just forget about.
That's what everyone thinks, that I should get on with things, stop living in the past.
Yeah, and you will do eventually. But that doesn't mean you're ever going to get over missing him.
I wouldn't want to. But I'd be like, you know, he ever existed.
So there you go, then.
I want to get on with life. I really do.
Believe you?
Just I look around and everyone seems to have something. You've got Max and the kids. Sammy's got Louise. Nisha's got more fellas than she knows what to do with. What have I got?
You've got me for the start.
It's not the same though, is it?
No, but it's something. And you never know what is round the corner. I mean, look at me. Who'd have thought I would have ended up with Max? And I couldn't be happier.
You always land on your feet.
You just need to stay positive, that's all. Leave this well alone. It only makes things worse. So unfair.
I bet they'd let you go, wouldn't they, Steve?
Yeah, but I'm a lot older.
Only a few years.
And I'm a lad.
What difference does that make?
Well, have you got any idea what goes on in places like Ayanapa?
Yeah. Why do you think we're going?
It's full of lads only after one thing.
Like you, you mean?
You should understand what I'm saying, Del.
I made a mistake, and no one in this family's ever going to let me forget that.
So why do you want to go repeating it?
I'm not going to. And anyway, we know about protection.
Oh, the pill.
Yeah.
And what about the rest? I've known lads come back from there with all sorts. STDs you couldn't even spell. And they've slept with half a dozen girls, some the same age as you. No condoms and nothing.
Well, we'll be careful.
We're not a couple of slappers. We're going on holiday.
There's going to be lads out there my age and older. They know exactly what to say to get some silly 16-year-old into bed with them.
Can't imagine you'd have to say much.
Yeah, well, we're not talking about me.
I can look after myself.
Can you?
Yeah.
Oh, you think you can, but there's a difference.
Who does he think he is?
I think he is cute.
Well, if it isn't the Manor Park one.
Jay, it's not funny.
You've got to admit, though, it's a bit of a switch.
How's that?
Well, a black lad waiting outside the cop shop for his white girlfriend to be released.
Well, this was supposed to be a free country.
Well, it is. As long as your face fits and you don't upset anyone.
All I was doing was trying to stop and pick on that little ginger lad.
So did he charge you?
No, just patronised me to death. Give me a big lecture about interfering with a police officer during the course of his duties.
Is that all?
Now, if they wanted to know what was a nice-looking girl like me doing hanging around with a bunch of scruffy students.
And what did you say?
I told them I was a scruffy student.
Welcome to the real world, Nick.
Oh, what's all this?
Well, it's just my way of apologising for being such a letdown on Valentine's Day. And I've managed to get Harry and Emma down so I can make it up to you properly, if you like.
Might be a bit tricky. Hiya. It's a birthday.
Happy birthday, Katie.
Can I use your papa's toilet? Yeah?
What are you for?
Oh, Max, I'm sorry, but she was in a right state when I got there. She wouldn't even let me in for ages.
Well, she seems okay now.
Well, I couldn't just leave her. She's been really low, and I've only just got her back. I didn't want to leave her.
So much for our planned evening.
Well, there'll be other evenings, won't there?
Well, it's a pity you didn't have that sort of attitude on Valentine's Day.
That is different and you know it is.
Yeah, what about the evening that I'd had planned for us? You want me to be more romantic, and when I am, you're too busy looking after every waif and stray that you come across.
Hey, Casey is not every waif and stray, she's my best mate.
Yeah, and I'm your bloody husband.
Get this place back on its feet.
It was you that brought it to its knees.
But it's over now. Forget it.
It's not over. Not by a long way. What if she'd called you bluff?
She didn't.
What if she had? You'd see her walk in the streets rather than back down, wouldn't you?
You're the best mate I've ever had. But our friendship, it's a bit of a sham now, isn't it?
That's tomorrow's Brookie at 8:30. Next up tonight on 4, the young couple are on the hunt for a home with a bit of wow factor in England's greenest Sheffield.
Over.
How are you feeling?
I shouldn't have stayed last night.
Don't be daft.
I don't think Max was too happy.
Nothing to do with him.
All those flowers. He had something planned, didn't he?
Look, Casey, you're my mate. And when you need me, I'll be there for you. He's just gonna have to learn to live with that. I'll be a minute.
Oh, look out! Here comes the man of part one!
You and all, Ginny.
How does it feel like having a criminal record, eh?
She's not a criminal. She's a prisoner of conscience.
You think this is funny?
Well, after you not taking the money off Tim, refusing to have anything to do with crime, I think it's hilarious, yeah?
I haven't done any crime. I was arrested for nothing.
Well, I told you not to get involved, didn't I?
You saw what they were doing to that little ginger fella. There was two of them, twice his size. All I said was take it easy.
Well, rule number one, Nicky, never question the busies.
I never questioned them. I just said there was no need, that's all. I mean, how's that interfering with a police officer?
Get real, Nicky. These things happen.
Best not to get involved. Just put it down to experience and move on. Listen, I'm going to see Bev. Shall I tell her you're available for work tonight or what?
Yeah, but don't go mentioning the other thing.
As if! See you later, Papillon.
I just can't believe they can get away with treating people like that.
Nicky, you got away with this. Let's just forget it now.
I got away with it. How did I get away with it? They arrested me.
But you weren't charged.
They made a show of me. And they took away my freedom.
For a couple of hours?
Yeah, well, it doesn't matter. It's the principle of the thing. I've got basic human rights and they just ignored them.
Nick, I know how annoying it can be. I grew up with it. But it's over now. Forget it.
It's not over. Not by a long way. I'm going to make an official complaint.
Cyprus, 22 degrees centigrade, 72 degrees Fahrenheit, sunny.
Forget it, though.
Brookside close. 0 degrees centigrade, 0 degrees Fahrenheit, frosty.
The subject's closed.
Not for me, it isn't.
Which part of you're not going to Iron Napa don't you understand?
What part of I'm 16 and can do what I like don't you understand?
Oh, can we change the subject? It's my day off, I don't want to spend it arguing about holidays.
I'm not arguing.
Neither am I. Good. Let's just keep it that way.
Did they hit you?
No.
Did they charge you?
You know they didn't.
So what is there to complain about?
Wrongful arrest.
Were you in the middle of a crowd of protesters?
Yeah.
And did you get into an argument with a busy?
Yeah.
So you're a student protester arguing with a police officer in the middle of a street? Nicky, you've got no chance.
Oh, so you think it's right that they can just arrest people whenever they feel like? Then let them go after a couple of hours of the slap on the wrist?
No, but...
And then they do that, and they expect you to be grateful.
Well, you should be grateful.
Why?
Because, believe me, it could have been worse, a lot worse.
And it could have been better. It didn't have to be like that. It was a peaceful protest. Now, if people complain...
If you start trying to make trouble for the police, Nicky, they'll make trouble for you, only they'll do it a lot better.
So you think I should just let them get away with it?
I remember. Once when my dad tried to press charges on them when I was a kid. Every time the doorbell went, we thought it was them. Every time he stepped outside, he was stopped and searched.
It's not like that anymore.
It's just not worth it, Nicky. Let's put it all behind us and forget it ever happened. All right, Ray. Come in.
I'm surprised at you, Nicola.
And who told you?
Jimmy.
Got caught up in a demonstration against student loans, Ray. Is that illegal all of a sudden?
Not that I know of.
And it's supposed to be a free country, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, so I have committed no crime, all right. So if you've come round here to give me a big lecture, you can just forget about it.
I've come round to see Jerome, actually.
Oh, all right.
Don't worry about getting arrested. It happens. But I wouldn't tell your nan about you.
Thanks, Ray. I'll leave you to it.
Is she all right? Did they treat her okay?
Yeah, she's just a bit angry, that's all.
Oh, she'll get over it.
So what do you want?
I want to ask you a couple of things about the insurance.
Yeah?
I've had this letter from Lucy, and they're going to come down to discuss it. I've got the feeling that they think that we're claiming over the odds.
Well, you know what insurance companies are like.
You didn't bump your claim up, did you?
No.
Oh, good, then. We're all right, then. Are you going into work tonight?
Yeah.
Could you do me a favour?
So you come round here, accuse me of fiddling the insurance, and then you try to ask me for a favour?
No, I'm not accusing you of anything. I'm just asking about the facts, you know.
Go on, then.
Well, sir, I was wondering whether you'd have a word with Helen for me.
Can't you do it?
No, she's told me she never wants to see me again.
Yeah, well, maybe you should leave it alone, then.
She's only saying that because of Jessie's interference. You know, she thinks she's coming between us.
And she is, isn't she?
Well, it's got nothing at all to do with Jessie. I mean, she's got no right to stick her nose in. Look, would you mind sort of saying to Helen that Jessie's not a problem and I would definitely like to see her again? Would you do that for me? Oh, please, come on. You're going to see her at work anyway.
All right, yeah.
Ah, oh, it's a good lad. Thanks a lot. If you don't mind, I'll come in later to see what she says. OK?
I bet you're glad you took the day off today. I was expecting a birthday hangover. Harry, come here, mate, while I put your top on. Feeling the best about things today, then? Better get on with it, haven't you?
Yeah.
Harry, I won't tell you again. Come here while I put your top on. Excuse me. I'm not chasing after you. Oh, you're being a naughty boy. Wait till we get that for us.
Hello. He's not here. Speak to his daughter if you want. 6 weeks and 2 days. He's on holiday. Well, his daughter looks after great grannies for him now. Hang on a minute. Someone complained about the cleaner.
God, not again. Hello, Miss Dixon speaking.
You're going to lounge around the house all day?
Going out in a minute. Is that all right, or do you want to come and hold my hand?
Where are you going?
Shopping.
Oh, are you going for anything special?
A bikini, sunglasses, and a big box of condoms.
Do you think talking like that's going to change our minds?
Sit down, Marty.
I don't care if you change your mind. I'm just making a point.
Yeah, and what point's that?
That I'm an adult, and you two are going to have to start treating me like one.
Right. If that's the way you want it.
Hey, Bev. You better be here to pay me my money back.
I haven't got it.
Then go away.
Lance tells me that you and him have made up.
You still here?
You've done the right thing there, Bev. He was a complete total innocent.
I know.
Same as myself, really. You'd obviously realise that now.
And what makes you think that?
Well, in the heat of the moment, you were talking about handing me into the busies, weren't you? And you didn't do that, did you?
No.
That's because when it comes to the milk of human kindness, you're the local dairy, aren't you? Ed McLaughlin.
I'm the stupid cow, is what you mean. But not anymore.
You didn't grass me up, and I appreciate that.
I didn't grass you up because I was ashamed to admit what an idiot I was. But if you don't get going right now, I just might change my mind.
Look, Bev, I'm trying to apologise.
I don't want your apologies.
Will you let me explain?
Let me explain. Now, when I left this country, I had a good business on the go there. Oh, it was a little gold mine. It ran itself. I had a good income. I could put a few bob away each week for Josh. Everything was hunky-dory. And now I'm back. And do you know what I'm reduced to? Cleaning my own windows. And do you know whose fault that is?
Christie's.
Yours. You were supposed to keep things ticking over.
I made a mistake, I know that. And I want to pay you back.
How?
In kind. If you give me my job back,
are you joking?
I just want a chance to prove how sorry I am.
I'm giving you your last chance, girl.
Just let me help you get this place back on its feet.
It was you that brought it to its knees.
So I owe you one. Let me help you.
Go away.
I'll do the windows for you if you like. Give us the bucket.
You'll regret that. Not as much as I'd regret giving you your old job back.
There you are. You can have that. Take it with you.
You mean I can go?
Yeah, you can go. It's like you said, you're an adult now. There's nothing I can do to stop you.
What are you on about, Marty?
She's been right all along, Di. She's very mature.
I mean, I can understand why you've both been worried. But honest, there was really no need.
There it is. Accommodation to let. You can take that with you.
He doesn't mean that.
Oh, you haven't been listening, Di. She's 16. She's not our responsibility anymore.
Stop it, Marty.
She can do what she likes. She can get pregnant. She can go on holiday. She can pay her own rent. She can cook her own tea. She can do her own ironing. She can do all her own washing and cleaning. She's not a schoolgirl anymore. She's a fully grown adult, and we've got to treat her like one. So there you go. You know where the door is. Pack your bags and go and stand on your own two feet in the big bad world. What are you waiting for?
Stay where you are, Adele.
You're pathetic.
And you're going nowhere.
I'm going, all right.
No, you're not.
Take no notice.
Can't wait to get out of this house.
Don't be stupid. Look, stop it, both of you. There's no need for any of this.
I'm going when I'm good and ready, and not when he tells me to.
That was pathetic.
I made me point.
I thought we were going to wait for one of the other parents to put the foot down.
She got on me nerves.
What if she'd called you bluff?
She didn't.
What if she had? You'd see her walk in the streets rather than back down, wouldn't you?
It won't come to that. She likes her home comforts too much.
We can't rely on that, Marty. She's growing up sooner or later.
What would you have me do? Give in? Tell her she can go?
No.
So you tell me then, what is the best way of dealing with this?
I don't know.
Can you believe that? Jesse Shadwick didn't turn in for work again this morning. Hey, can you keep an eye on these two for a bit while I go and see what's going on?
I suppose so.
Oh, no, you know what? It doesn't matter. I'll ring it instead.
I wouldn't mind Violente £500 after that fight and she letting me down like this.
Listen, Jack, I'd better get going.
Oh, it won't take me a minute.
No, I'm in the way here.
Oh, no, I'm glad of the company.
But you've got a lot on your plate and I don't want to be here when Max gets home. Max will be out all day. You won't be back till late tonight and you can stay as long as you like. Harry, turn that off, will you?
No, I'd rather go. Thanks for putting up with me.
Oh, that's what makes it forward, isn't it?
Harry, I said turn it off.
Oh, no, come on. You don't have to go back to work today, do you? Maybe we could spend the day all together with the kids and cheer you up. Oh.
Jack, you're the best mate I've ever had. For our friendship. It's a bit of a sham now, isn't it?
Why?
You've got April the 5th marked off on your calendar.
I thought we got through all that.
I got it put down on the dumps yesterday. No, it was my 26th birthday and I've got no future. Nothing to look forward to. It gave me a shoulder to cry on.
Yeah, but you'd do the same for me, wouldn't you?
The thing is, in 6 weeks' time, the man who blew my future away is getting out of jail. And you're going to celebrate that day. Because that man's your dad.
We can work all that out.
Maybe. But I'll never forget it, Jack. I can't just pretend it didn't happen. I'll see you.
Oh.
She's not done a roller, then?
Not yet.
Has that racket been going on all day?
No. She went shopping with Laura this afternoon.
What did she buy?
I didn't ask. I've hardly seen her. She had a tea in her room.
Do you know, I think I liked it better when she was into Kate Bush. I mean, with a lyric every now and then kill them. What's the matter?
You sound like my dad.
I sound like my dad.
And did your dad ever let you go on holiday with your mates when you were 16?
He wasn't happy about it.
So you went?
That was different.
How?
Well, we were lads, and it was real.
So?
So it's different and you know it. I and Napa, it's all sex and drugs and... well, and nothing else.
So what was real?
Games of Space Invaders down the Black Cat and a couple of cans of Kessler in a caravan.
We're worried about Anthony because he doesn't want to do what normal kids do of his age. And we're worried because Adele does.
Do you think I went over the top this morning?
I think you're playing a dangerous game.
I don't like being the narky parent, you know. I'd be happy for you to take over if you think you can do a better job.
No, thanks. I was the bad cop over all the abortion stuff. It's my turn to be good cop.
You don't actually want her to go on the holiday, do you?
No. But if we have many more standoffs like we had this morning, she will leave home, and we don't want that either, do we?
No.
Max, it's only me. I only rang you for a chat, really. Nothing important. I'll speak to you later, then. Bye. Right, you two. Are you bored of this yet?
No.
Hey, well, I am, so I think it was time you went to bed, OK? Go on, go upstairs and be quiet while Mummy makes a phone call. I'll come up and read you a bedtime story in a minute. Katie? Hiya. Yeah, it's me. Look, I just wondered if you fancy coming over. Max is going to be working until midnight, and to be honest, I've been stuck in all day since you left me this morning with the kids. Couldn't have to do some asshole conversation. Well, I thought we could talk about what you were saying before.
To be honest with you, Jack, I don't think there's much left to say to you. I haven't fallen out with you at any minute. It's just, you know, I'm already out with Nisha. She was working on my birthday, so I'm going out to celebrate it tonight. Yeah, you too. Bye.
That's full 60, please.
Thanks. Another vodka and tonic, please, Bev.
Are you meeting someone?
No.
Oh, well, don't forget to spread the word. Bev's bar's back under old management, just like the good old days.
Tell your mates.
Yeah, right. Hey, guess who turned up here this morning?
Who?
Only Leanne Powell, wanting her old job back.
You didn't give it to her, did you?
No way. Learnt me a lesson as far as that one's concerned, eh? Chucked a bucket of dirty water all over her. Right in her face.
Serves her right.
So, if you see her hanging around, give me a shout.
Oh, don't worry. Well, is she barred?
No, I can't afford to bar anyone, but just keep your eye out for her.
But will you be able to manage with a broken ankle? But, Mum, are you going to get your shopping in or do the housework? Are you sure? But why don't you let me know as soon as it happened? Hang on a sec, Mum. Excuse me, you two, you be quiet. Sorry about that, Mum. These kids are playing off. Listen, I can try and come over this weekend if you like.
I don't suppose Jerome's home from work yet, is he?
No.
Well, would anyone mind if I came in and waited for him?
There's no one in anyway. They're all out, so come in.
Oh, thanks. So how are you after your ordeal, then?
Oh, I'm OK. Just can't believe it happened.
Did you have to share a cell?
No, I was in on my own.
Oh, that's a good thing. If you're not in for long, you know.
Yeah, I was glad of it, yeah.
But if you're in for a bit longer, it's good to have a bit of company.
Hang on. How do you know?
Well, when I was young, I was in the army, you know. And I got into a few scrapes.
What do you mean, a few scrapes?
Well, I know what the inside of a jail looks like.
How long have you been in for?
Well, the longest I ever got was 56.
Days?
Yeah, but I only did 30.
And what was it for?
Fighting. We wrecked the corporal's mess.
Oh, right. Okay, I'm coming.
They put you in this concrete shed, you see, with no windows, like, you know. The front wall is all bars, and you're on your bread and water and stuff. And you've got a little bed, a little cot, and a bucket. You're supposed to wee in the bucket, but we never did.
Well, why not?
Well, you had to keep it clean. Sparkling like silver, you know. But anyway, you had to use it like when you came out of solitary for the work.
And what type of work did you do?
Digging.
Well, what's the point in that?
They were trying to break us down, I think. You used your mate's bucket one day, and your own the next. And that way you only had to clean yours every other day, like.
I know what you had to do makes mine sound like nothing, but at least you'd done something wrong. I hadn't.
Hey, here's the lad himself. Did you manage to have a word with Helen?
I did, yeah.
What does she say?
It's bad news, Ray. She doesn't want to see you again. She won't change her mind.
I don't even think we should mention it anymore.
Ignoring the problem won't make it go away.
Maybe it will. Maybe we're making too big a deal of it.
I don't get you.
Well, how much is it going to cost her to go?
To know.
Including her spends. 300 or 400 quid, I bet. Easy. Where's she going to get that from? She's only got a part-time job in the garage. You know what she's like for spending money. She came back with 2 carrier bags full today. They can't all be condoms.
Aye, do you have to?
And she spends 17 quid a month on contact lenses. What I'm saying is, she's never going to be able to save up the money to pay for this holiday.
You're probably right there.
And if she hasn't got the money, she just can't go. So what are we worried about?
That's spot on, though. No wonder I married you.
From now on, no more arguments about Ayanapa. The next time she mentions it, we just say, yeah, OK, Del, whatever. Send us a postcard.
Then we can both be good cop.
I mean, things are picking up. Slowly.
Great. Well, shall I tell Nicky to come in tomorrow, then, or what?
Yeah, she can do the afternoon shift if she wants. Gives me a break.
Yeah, well, you could do with one, couldn't you?
It's hard work, but I'm starting to see the light at the end of the tunnel.
Me too.
Thanks for tonight.
No problems.
See you tomorrow.
Yeah, see ya.
He was telling me tonight he was in jail for fighting in Malaya.
I thought soldiers were supposed to fight.
Not each other.
Oh, hey, you two been swapping prison stories, have you? That was a holiday camp compared to what I had to put up with, young lady.
It wasn't all.
So why are you bothering to make a complaint?
Maybe I won't. I mean, the worst I had to put up with was sly digs about taxpayers' money and lefty students.
And that's nothing, believe me.
I just hate the fact that no one takes you seriously because you think you're a lefty student. I mean, as if I'm a lefty student.
You're not even going to be a student for much longer, so I don't know why you got yourself involved in the first place.
Jay, I didn't get myself involved, or I should have done. You know, I was in the back of that police van. You know, the ginger lad I got arrested with. He asked me he was going to that demo next month.
The demo?
Yeah, you know, the NUS one in London, about the student loans.
So?
Well, do you fancy it?
But I thought you were dropping out.
Change your mind. Why should I back in? I'm not going to let them get me down. I'm going to go to that demo next month. And I'm going to finish my course as well. Lost orders, Bev.
Didn't do a good enough job, I was away, so she's come to finish me off.
Oh, I've got no idea where she lives.
I reckon my Jerome will be able to find out her address. You just leave it to me.
Honey, you are a naughty, naughty boy. You don't touch this phone again.
Oh, do you think I'm heading for one?
You know yourself best.
I feel great.
That's tomorrow's Brookside at 8:30.
Coming up, Four follows a police team investigating sex crimes, from allegations of sexual harassment at work to the rape of an elderly woman. That's next.
Morning, Meg.
Hello, love.
Oh, is that everything for the house?
Yeah, yeah, it's all here.
Right, we just need to create a file on the computer. That's all for Jimmy face, so.
Will he mind?
No. Jimmy.
Oh. Ah, that's where it got to, eh? Suit you that.
Sorry. Got a bit cold about 5 o'clock and I didn't like to put your heating on. I was asking you.
You've been working all night?
Most of it, yeah.
Oh, that's it. You throw yourself back into it, cadet. No more talk of dropping out.
That's it. Ray's come round, he's saying he's got the estimates to do, you know, about the house. Just wondering, can I use your computer, put it on this phone?
No probs, yeah, you know where it is. Cup of tea, Ray.
Oh, yeah.
Right, I'm going to get dressed for you so you can have your dressing gown back.
Heady days for you, kidda.
Hey?
Rebuilding the house from scratch. Ultimate fantasy for a DIY fanatic.
Not exactly, Jim. Under different circumstances, maybe.
All the quotes fair and square, are they?
Yeah, we get the bungalow back to what it was, you know, but I'd quite like a bit of extra space, you know, a couple of rooms, possibly.
Ah, you'll cheer up once you start telling those architects and builders how to do the jobs, I know you.
Mmm.
What?
Well, we'll rebuild the house, all right. I'm not so sure about our marriage.
Huh? Jesse's still got a knock about you having another family.
I know you thought the same at first.
Well, I didn't expect it from you, I suppose. Look, the woman exists. You don't need me making things more difficult for you.
You're a mate. It's different for Jesse.
Wives are dispensable, Ray. Kids aren't.
Oh, see ya.
I should put you on the spot, having a stash of cash.
I will tell him. Of course I will.
Your money, your business.
When you get married, your money's never your own, whatever it's for. Can't exactly have a baby without him.
Do you want to go for dinner today?
Yeah, I'll see you back here.
No, I mean out. My treat.
You've given me enough.
Oh, come on. Well, I've got it.
What's this about?
I don't know. Isn't it round about this time that you need some company? Maybe a cake or three?
It's a sad state of affairs when your whole family know your cycle.
Yeah, well, just let's say I know when to stay out of the way if you're left, though.
Harry! Ha-ha, caught you. Did you escape from your mummy?
Harry, how many times do I have to tell you, mate? You mustn't run on the road.
How's it going?
Oh, great. Fine.
Haven't seen you much since you became a wife and mum.
Well, we don't get to see much of anyone, do we? Apart from you and Emma.
Well, if you ever need a hand, you know where I am.
Well, you work, I don't.
Being a mum's the hardest job of all. If you need a break or you and Max want a night out, just give me a shout.
Thanks. I'll see you later.
See ya.
12:30, okay, then?
I'll be ready.
All right, see
you later. There you go, Ray. Hard copy of everything you need.
Oh, much appreciated.
Everything sorted?
Yeah, thanks.
Grace, I think I'll get myself into work then. And then Bev appreciates a little extra at the moment.
I won't be able to start for another hour. I've got so much to do. I never even made it into the student welfare the other day.
You shouldn't go and get yourself arrested then, should you? That's okay. I think I can handle everything she needs. See you later.
See you later. Right, you think he's a bit hyper?
Nah, no. He just likes helping his friends.
Yeah, I've been keeping an eye on his mood swings.
Yeah, he's certainly had a change of heart about me. I just wish your nan could.
Well, that's up to you. You've got to start by telling her the truth, telling her everything. Instead of letting her find out bit by bit.
But I know so little.
Ray?
Well, I just don't want to upset her any more than I have already.
And what about Helen?
Well, you know, she's made her mind up. She made that clear to Jerome. She just doesn't want to know.
And that's all right by you, is it?
No, it's not. No. No.
Oh, Ray.
When did this happen?
She didn't do a good enough job while I was away, so she's come to finish me off.
Who, Leanne?
Who do you think?
There you go, Ray.
I'm sorry about that, love. It all got a bit much. The fire and everything, you know.
Ray, you just found your daughter. Can't sit in those feelings. I can't even think what it all must mean to you.
No.
She always knew she was out there somewhere, though.
Yeah, I suppose so.
You must have. I mean, didn't you think about her all the time?
Oh, I couldn't afford to.
What do you mean?
Well, I did at first, you know, I had a rough idea when the baby was going to be born, but then I found out it's a girl. My little girl.
And didn't you want to see her?
Well, yes and no. Decisions had to be made, you know. At the time, it was thought better if I stayed away.
And how on earth did you manage that?
I had put my thoughts to one side, you know, pack them away like in a box. I knew they were in there, but I didn't dare take a look at them.
Well, now she's found you. I mean, a daughter and a granddaughter all at once. It must be so exciting for you.
Not that I can show. You know, I've been looking at little Beth lately, and I've realised what I've been missing. And you and Emily, all those ages and the stages and that.
Now old your granddaughter?
Stephanie? She's 12.
Ah, you sound proud.
Yeah, all I've got is a photo.
I know you only met by chance, but it's not fair if Helen backs off again. You should go and see her.
Oh, I don't know. Work doesn't seem right. I've got no idea where she lives.
Well, the box is open now. You're a father and a grandfather. Only you should miss out on that any longer. I reckon Jerome could find out her address. You leave it to me.
Jimmy, it's not worth it.
Of course it's worth it. It's worth showing the likes of Leanne Powell you're unstoppable.
Yeah, well, maybe I'm not.
Oh, some party.
Yeah, well, you want to ask your Christie about it, don't you?
Christie?
Christie is Leanne!
Jimmy, we're not sure.
Aren't we? No sign of a break-in. Who else do we know with a set of keys, eh? Furniture scratched. Equipment wrecked, every last optic and bottle smashed. Gin, vodka, whiskey. The lot. So, table for two, was it?
We'll leave you to it.
No need.
He's winding you up.
I am not.
Look, Jimmy, we can't serve people when there's nothing
What's
to serve
happened?
Them with.
Of course we can. I'm sure we can scrape together a bit of a sandwich and a cup of coffee.
Yeah, well, the coffee machine is out of order.
What's wrong with an old-fashioned kettle and a bit of instant?
Jimmy, will you stop badgering the poor people? Look, at the shelves open.
They don't want to be paying those prices. Listen, give us a couple of minutes and I'll have you seated up in that conservatory. You'll love it up there. Perfect for you. Nice and quiet. Go on, up you go. Up you go! Bev, you make me laugh. Turning away good customers. What are you playing at?
Bev? Now, I said you could play the plastic one, so don't play with the pans, right? How did you find that?
Oh, no. Hello?
Edith.
I'm so sorry. Well, I didn't realise that he had the phone. Don't you tell me how to bring up my children. Yeah, with pleasure. Honey, you are a naughty, naughty boy. You don't touch this phone again. I'm sorry. Mummy didn't mean to shout. I'm sorry. I'm sorry, okay? We need to pay off our debts first.
The debts will always be there.
As long as we're chucking good money away, yeah?
Well, don't you want another shot at getting pregnant?
What do you think? Everything all right for you?
Of course it is. Triumph in adversity. We won't be intimidated.
I'm just nipping to the loo.
So what did the busy say?
No, we're not bothering with that useless lot. We'll sort this one ourselves. Bev's gonna wait for the right moment. On you, kiddie. Leanne Powell will find out that she's an amateur when it comes to revenge.
Okay, let's not get too carried away, eh, Jim?
She's a bit distressed.
Look, I don't know what I want to do about Leanne, so let's not go public just yet.
Okay, okay, I'm just being supportive.
Yeah, well, less of the physical. There's no point setting up those tables.
That's defeatist talk, that.
Did you manage to have a word with Jerome?
Well, he's not happy about playing go-between again, Ray. But I told him how important it was to you. So here's your daughter's address.
Oh, great. Fantastic.
Raimundo! We need a man of your skills.
Oh, I'm sorry, Jimmy. I'm too busy today.
Thanks.
Look, your loo's are in a real mess. There's no paper and there's no sanitary towels in the machine. I might have something in me back. Look, don't worry. I'd rather nip home or back to work. Sorry.
You see, Bev, there's always someone worse off than you. How long have you been trying for a baby die? Years, isn't it? Hey, is that another disappointment for you again this month?
Jimmy!
People's houses burning down, long-lost daughters turning up out of the woodwork, students getting arrested just because they've got an opinion about the futures. I mean, a few broken bottles not going to upset anyone, is it, Di? Hey, you must be feeling devastated.
Hey, she doesn't need the whole world knowing about it, all right?
I'm just saying.
I need to go home. How much do we owe you?
We're not paying.
No, nothing.
Bev, you're running a business here.
Steve, I need to go.
Come on.
Look, I'm really sorry with you having to put up with everything.
Put up with nothing? They got a free lunch there. Look, Bev, if you're not going to charge, you've got no chance. Right. What needs doing now?
Your mouth. It needs shutting.
Hiya. I was starting to think I was going to have me dinner on my own. Do you want a sandwich?
No, I've had something. I've just got to pop upstairs.
You alright?
One of those days.
It's been one of them years. We need a holiday. All of us. Just wish I had the means.
I wasn't quite sure what to do with this. Put it in the bank. Or keep it in the house. Yeah. It's £500. What have you done with them?
They're outside.
I think they've been banished.
They're happily making mud pies.
Oh, great. Another pile of washing to do. Do you know, all I seem to do is tell them off. Hattie's phoned the emergency services twice so far today. Emma's pulled everything out of them cupboards about 100 times. She wouldn't even let me go to the toilet before.
Do you want to go now?
No, I've been. Just never on my own.
Is it that time of the...
Oh, please.
Well, it is, isn't it?
What's that got to do with it?
A lot.
Oh, making a note in your diary, are you?
No, no, you just get to know about these things, that's all.
Yeah, I'm sure you do, and you've lived with as many women as you have.
Jackie?
Well, I don't know if I'm as predictable as Faye or Susanna or Patricia. With your information, I'm all over the place at the minute. Just stick that in your diary. Oh, I just want to have some fun with them.
I'm sure you do.
No, I don't. They're going to start thinking the names are Harry, don't do that, and Emma, stop it. She chucked a shoe in before I flushed. You can wipe that smell off your face. It was one of yours.
When did he give it to you?
The other day.
The housekeeping? Why didn't you say?
Why didn't you tell me about the insurance scam?
Because it was dishonest. Where'd he get it?
Foreigners.
He said he was doing all right. Why did he give it to you?
How do you mean?
Why didn't he give it to us together? Did he say what it was for?
A contribution like you've been asking for.
A contribution toward what?
The endless bills that keep piling up. I don't know. We said we'd move on. £500 could make a big difference. I'm not expecting anything from it.
Hey, he's cracking up again.
Give him a moment to get himself together.
Yeah, well, he can do it at home because I really don't need this today.
Will you let me have a few minutes with him?
Okay.
Jimmy?
Have you seen the state of this?
Got a drink for you, dear. Let's have a sit down, eh?
No, no time. Gotta get this done for tonight.
No, Bev says it's okay. Yeah. I know you're keen to help, but you've got to look after yourself as well.
True.
Have you been writing in your self-management journal again this week?
Off and on.
Look, I know I'm no expert, but I did learn a lot from doing that essay, and, well, what I learned from you.
Oh, do you think I'm heading for one?
You know yourself best.
You're great. Look, I'm not saying there hasn't been a challenging time, you know, for me best mates, but I'm right there with them. You know, problem shared, that's a problem halved, isn't it? Here. Even made a bit of a note in my journal. Look. Been one or two high points. Even had sex this week. See? Didn't believe me when I said, did you?
Look, you know what your own triggers are. And yeah, it's fine being a friend, but you can't take on the world and its worries. Yeah, we can do an exercise if you want. Well, if you're up for it.
Such as?
I don't know. Try telling yourself out loud all this stuff happening around you can't get to you.
Somewhere else, eh?
Well, for instance?
I don't know. Ray Hilton. Ray Hilton's a mate, but his problems aren't mine. Go on.
Ray Hilton's a mate, but his problems aren't mine.
Great, but louder now. Nicky Shadwick getting arrested isn't my problem.
Oh, but hey.
Big and loud. Go on.
Nicky Shadwick getting arrested isn't my problem.
Nice one.
Hey, what is this? Primal scream therapy? I mean, I'm the one who's supposed to be falling apart here.
Bev's bar getting vandalised isn't my responsibility.
And who else is going to give you the job?
It's not as if we're getting paid, Bev.
Well, that depends how you view payment, Jimmy.
Stephanie.
Making a mess of everything, having a lovely time.
Some of these clothes are dry.
Oh, look, I'm sorry I got so tense.
Well, I did say that some days will be harder than others.
Yeah, you did.
Look, you're doing amazingly well with them.
Thanks. But whatever you say, I'm just going to think you're being condescending. You know, they need better stimulation than I can give them. They can't be getting told off every 5 minutes just for being kids.
Look, don't judge anything on today.
On a premenstrual, you mean?
Well, I wouldn't dream of telling you when to start your period.
You know, I can take them swimming and to playgroup, but I really think that they're missing the nursery, you know, kids their own age around them.
Well, you've always had the idea of starting a crèche at the club, so I suppose you could take them there for a few hours, eventually.
How long's eventually gonna be? I want to set it up.
Yourself?
Yeah. Is it unfair on them if I go back to work part-time?
Look, you're worried about everyone and everything at the moment. The kids, your dad, the club, Katie.
And now my mum's gone and broke her ankle.
Well, why don't you go and see her? Take a break from everything here before you decide on anything.
Oh, what about the kids?
Well, I think the change will do them the world of good too.
Time off from me.
No, 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 you'd want to take them with you.
Oh, yeah, of course. Of course I would.
You can't tell us what to spend it on, otherwise he shouldn't have given it to us.
But he didn't give it to us, did he?
For us.
For one reason and one reason only.
It's not like he's in his will, Mart.
Will you stop being so noble? You haven't talked about wanting a baby for ages.
I promised I wouldn't.
Doesn't mean the desire's gone, though, does it? You think I don't know what goes on inside?
I keep volunteering to mind all the babies on the close. I read somewhere that if you spend a lot of time around other people's children, it might increase your chances. Oh, it's pathetic, isn't it? I've just totally frightened off Jackie Farnham this morning.
You never stood a chance of conceiving this past year. That was what we've all been through.
Hopefully the worst is over.
Hope. That's what the Murrays need. Something to look forward to. We're not going to touch that money. What we're going to do is add to it, bit by bit. And before you know it, we'll have enough for another go.
We don't have to.
Yeah, we do. And for the record, it's my decision, OK?
OK.
Who are you? Why are you looking at me like that?
Don't worry, I'm your...
Mom?
Bev shouldn't be on her own.
She'll phone if she needs us.
You shouldn't be here with me.
Don't be daft.
That's what all Lindsay had to do in the end. Yeah, get out of my way. Can't blame her. Still, you've got no choice, have you? You know, having a house that's a mess of charcoal. Yeah.
Look, Jim, if all of us being here is too much for you, then you've just got to stay. Means you don't, we'll go and find somewhere else to live today. You've always done loads for us. Not just since the fire, well before. If you hadn't taken our Emily, and I don't know what would have happened to her and Tim. I'm not stupid. I don't even want to think about where they're getting the money. But, well, at least they're living close by. They're near to family. And that's because of you. If there's anything at all I can do to thank you for that, then I want to do it. I'm not going anywhere, Jimmy.
With you yet, let alone my 12-year-old daughter.
For something like that to happen, she must have really upset someone along the line.
Oh, there you go. I knew there was one in there somewhere.
What?
A smile.
You bitch! Get off me!
Pub number two, please.
Oh, the claws are out in Brookside. Double bill, Wednesday from 8 and 4. Friday comedy next tonight when Father Ted hatches an elaborate plan that'll drive you round the bend. Stay with 4.